Hey guys, welcome back. Today I want to talk about a HIFi product. So this is going to be an audio review. Behind me I have hooked up here the new Dynaudio Heritage Special speakers. Now if any of you have been following my HIFi journey over the years, I can get pretty passionate about my audio reviews. I'm not going to sit here in this video and scream and yell and tell you go buy these speakers, they're the best things ever. But what I am going to tell you is words from my heart about these speakers. Now over at my website at stevehufffoto.com, I've written a 10,000 word review on these speakers. I was looking at comments and an older review of mine on another set of speakers, comment was something like, "This reads like a novel, wow," you know, and it's because when I write and when I'm truly excited about something, you can really read that in my writings. When I like something but I don't love it, you can kind of tell that as well. But these speakers here, the Dynaudio Heritage Specials, are limited to 2,500 pairs worldwide. They use some of Dynaudio's best drivers. The midwoofer is from their $85,000 speakers in the Evidence line. The tweeter is their best that they make, the Esotar 3, and it has a walnut veneer cabinet that kind of gives you that retro vibe, that vintage look, but to me, it's timeless, right? It looks beautiful, it looks like furniture, and the quality of the walnut veneer is really top-notch. It's another level from my Klipsch Heresy 4s, which I still have in the corner behind these right now. And I still love those Klipsch Heresy 4s. They're more raw, exciting, lively speaker compared to these. In the past, I've done videos on and written reviews on the Dynaudio Special 40s. Now, those are speakers I love as well. Those speakers are now, I think, at $3,500 retail. When I reviewed them, they were just under $3,000. These speakers here are $7,000 retail for the speakers. The stands, which I have them on the stand 20s, those are $500. And then you must buy a plate that goes on the stand 20 and allows you to bolt the speaker onto the plate. So they are coupled to the stands. So as you see them here in my room, this is a $7,600 retail speaker. Not cheap by any means for a stand mount speaker. The Special 40s again are $3,500. So do you get twice the performance of the Special 40s? I believe you do. I believe these are indeed for me my favorite bookshelf speakers I've ever owned. I've owned bookshelves, stand mounts that were $15,000. I've owned stand mounts that were $26,000. I like these better for a few reasons. First of all, they're not that efficient. They're 85 dB efficient, so you would think you would need a Superman of an amp to drive them. And you kind of do, but not really in the watts department. You need current. I'm driving them primarily with a Pass Labs INT-25, which I also reviewed here recently. And this has become my reference piece in this room. I've never had a better sounding integrated amplifier, no matter the cost. I may have been excited about other amps I paid a lot of money for, and they may have been amazing products and still are, but there's something about this integrated 25 class A watts that really provides a sweetness, a richness, a wide open transparent sound to whatever speaker I hook it up to. And I was a little worried thinking it wouldn't drive these Dynaudios very well, but I was very surprised and kind of shocked when I hooked them up, because with the Klipsch Heresy IVs, which are 99 decibel efficient, I usually would set my volume on 37 if I'm listening in here during the day. So I figured, oh, I might have to turn these up to 50 or 60 because they're not very efficient. Lo and behold, I listened to them at 38 and they sound just as loud as the Klipsch, but they're so much more refined. These are a refined speaker, about as refined as I've heard. The treble is, again, Dynaudio's best tweeter, the Esotar 3, made by Dynaudio. The mid driver's made by Dynaudio. The cabinet's made by Dynaudio. These speakers are made in Denmark and come with a 10-year warranty. And again, you get one of 2,500 pairs worldwide. Now, when I was like looking at them, I'm like, $7,000 seems kind of high for these speakers. But then I look back and I remember when Dynaudio released the Special 25 back, I believe, in 2002. I believe those were $5,200 when they launched. So I went to an inflation calculator, and lo and behold, those Special 25s back in 2002 at $5,200 would have been $7,100 today. So maybe Dynaudio went to the inflation calculator and figured out what they would price these for. And the Special 25 sold out and were so popular and sought after that Dynaudio eventually re-released them in a different finish from the original finish, just to satisfy the demand for that speaker. So it was kind of like two limited sets or something like that. These, Dynaudio says, no way, 2,500 sets and they're gone. I think in the United States, there's 750 allocated. And not all Dynaudio dealers are selling these, only select dealers. And me living out here in the middle of nowhere, I have zero audio dealers anywhere close or far, really, from me. And I bought these at Dedicated Audio in Scottsdale, Arizona, longtime customer. I know the owner, he's a wonderful guy, Dan. And he is selling these speakers, but he can't sell to anyone. You have to either be in the Southwest or not have a dealer anywhere near you like me, I guess. So they're not easy to find, and there's really no deals to be had on them because of the limited nature. So let's get into what I think about them compared to the Special 40, which is half the price, a fantastic punch above its weight speaker from Dynaudio. I said back when I reviewed the Special 40s, you really can't touch anything. You can't get anything near that price that performs like that. They punched well above their weight and still do. They had plump, fleshed out bass, a nice crisp tweeter, details for days, and depending on placement and amplification, you could either get a nice warm romantic sound from them or a little bit faster, leaner sound. And the same kind of goes for these. With my Pass Labs amp, I'm getting a huge, bigger sound than the S40s. Details, but they're not overly bright, they're not harsh or anything like that. But you have the detail that's there is so fine and airy and delicate, and I'm hearing a lot more stuff in my music with these speakers, but it's never fatiguing in any way. It's not like I'm listening and I'm like, ooh, these sound bright, because they're not thin. A lot of audiophile speakers that kill you with detail are also thin and grating, and they get on your nerves after a while. These have body and warmth and oomph, and the bass is not gonna jump out at you. It's not overly plump or ripe. It's there, it's in that body, but when the bass is called upon in the music, ooh, it could slam you with some impact. So top to bottom, these are very refined speakers that sound as one. They give you that nice, huge sound stage, wall to wall, depth, height, it's all there. The imaging is superb, but it's not that etched out kind of imaging. It's way more natural. It sounds like you're really listening to musicians playing rather than, oh, I hear this over here and this over here, and it looks like it's analytical and cut out and all surgical. No, these are musical speakers. You're not going to sit here and say, ooh, that tweeter's too bright, or oh, that bass is too weak, or these sound thin. If you run them with the right amplification and you're in a small room like mine, I have a 12 by 18 room, no subwoofer, I don't use subs. These do not need subs in a room like this. These will blow you away. I mean, they are, to me, they sound like speakers that are more expensive than what they cost. And while they cost a lot of money, there are times when you do get what you pay for. And it's not true that in audio you have to spend a fortune to enjoy music or get a really nice musical sound. That's not true. But there are exceptions where you do spend a lot of money and you do get this incredible performance. Again, I like these better than other stand mounts I've had that were $15,000 and $26,000. I like these better. They're more cohesive. They're more balanced. They offer you just such a pleasing musical sound. I could listen in here for hours and hours, and I have. And you just don't want to stop listening. It's like I was in my listening room one night. It was like 2 a.m. and I caught myself dozing off, and I'm like, oh, one more song, one more song. They can become addicting.
You keep the light on, you keep the light on, you keep the night light on. And then the rent is just a little too late. Ain't gonna be no birthday cake. You keep the light on, you keep the light on, you keep the night light on.
Speakers, amazing thing is that they're low volume champs. These beat out my Heresy 4s for low volume listening. They're still full, they still have that body. They're still magical, they're still special. They have that pure tonality to them and that mid-range. I believe these are built kind of like on a foundation of mid-range, right? And that is the most important part of the audio spectrum, in my opinion. That's where voices emerge. That's where the body of the music lie. And these are mid-range centric speakers with a silky, airy, detailed top end and a powerful, impactful, very quick and fast bass. It's almost like with some speakers, you hear the mid bass and bass together, lumped together. With these, you hear the mid bass, but you also hear that tight bottom end bass. Like you hear, I was listening to a song and I heard each pluck of the bass, but I almost heard like the fingers sliding on the strings, right? And I didn't notice that before in other speakers. So for me, these far exceed the Special 40s, as good as those speakers are. These are just some of the best speakers I've owned. And again, I have a pair that's one pair of 2,500 that will be available. They're very special in that regard. They look beautiful. They look like furniture. They're built to an extremely high standard. The back port is huge. The binding posts are the highest quality I've seen in any speaker I've bought, regardless of price. These are just all around masterpieces as far as I'm concerned.
Soon I will be done with the trouble of the world. Going home to live with God.
Now, one thing to know, I don't make commission on these videos. Most of my audio reviews are demonetized because I put song samples in and I get flagged and I can't monetize them. I don't have any affiliation with the dealer who sold them to me. I have zero affiliation with Dynaudio. They were not sent to me to review so I can just whip up and fast talk here and tell you how great they are. No, I paid for these with my own money. I've been burning them in my room with my ears. I've been writing notes and listening to them nonstop since they arrived, and they're just all out beautiful, refined, magical speakers that are some of the most musical at the same time. So I don't want to keep dragging this out. I just wanted to share my excitement with these and my reference system here. Now, this is, I was telling Debbie, this is going to retire me from audio reviews because I normally don't get things sent to me. What I review are things I buy. And I no longer have a desire to buy anything. I don't want any other speakers. I don't want any other amplifiers. My digital front end is pretty, it blows me away every time I listen to it. I just have a Blue Sound Node 2i streamer, which I highly recommend if you want to get into streaming. Don't pay that $2,000, $3,000, $4,000 for a streamer. Get something like a Blue Sound and add an external DAC to it if you want to bring the performance up even more. But you don't even need to add a DAC because it comes with one built in. But later on, if you want, you can step up the performance of it by adding a DAC. I run a Chord Cutest and a Chord M Scaler. And that M Scaler makes the sound almost like reel-to-reel tape. It sounds so analog, so juicy, so has a little bit of warmth to it. If you've heard Chord gear is bright and fatiguing, that's not the case with this combo anyway. It adds even more body and texture to the sound. So I have this complete reference system here, in my opinion, and there's nothing I want to change. I love my cables. I love everything about it. If I made any change, it would actually ruin the sound for me. So I have everything set up. I'm not planning on buying any more hi-fi gear for a long time, which means this might be one of my last audio reviews. I might not have an audio review for a long, long time because, again, unless a company wants to send me something to go against what I have here, I would happily do that. But I'm perfectly content. For the first time in a long time, I am content with my complete audio system. And if you're an audiophile, you know how ridiculous that sounds because audiophiles always are chasing that dream, that sound. It's more about the chase than the destination for some audiophiles. But for me, I've hit the destination. I'm getting older. I think this pandemic aged me 10 years in one. I just want to relax. I want to chill. I want to de-stress. Sit in my chair and recharge myself with the music. And with music as beautiful as these put out, it does that every night for me. I also like listening to older 80s recordings with these recordings I stopped listening to years ago because high-end systems made them sound like garbage. They sound amazing on this system. I've written much more about it in my written review, 10,000 words. If you're really interested in these speakers, I urge you to go sit down, relax, grab a coffee or something, a tea, and it's a good read, but it's a long read. It might make you really want these speakers because I'm speaking with passion from my heart and soul. And that's over at stevehufffoto.com. As a matter of fact, I'll link to the review in this description below. And I have listening notes and I go into much more detail.
In a world of change,
in my opinion, Dynaudio's best stand mount speaker. I think I might even prefer these to the higher up bookshelves they sell. I used to have a pair of C1s, the latest version of the C1s before they stopped making them. I like these much better. As a matter of fact, I didn't love the C1s. I thought they were overly warm and plump and a little obscured in the detail area. Almost to a fault, but that could have been my room at the time. It could have been the amp I was driving them with at the time. I remember I had brought those back to Dan at Dedicated a couple days, and I'm like, I bought his demos, and I'm like, I'm not really jiving with these, and you know, I bought something else. But these are the best Dynaudios I've heard from my tastes. 2,500 pair. I think right now they might be a little hard to find. I'm not sure. I think Dan said he's getting more in a couple weeks or something, but highly recommend, my highest recommendation if you're looking for one of those speakers that could be your last speaker, right? Now, if you're in a big room, you're going to need to drive these with more power, something like Pass Labs Integrated 250, and there's a million amplifiers you can drive these with. Just don't try to run them with an AVR. Those are not really meant for speakers such as this. That's great for home theater, but these require quality amplification, most of all current. Don't really look at watts, look at current. I can tell you these love Class A amplification. So that's my recommendation to you. So I thank you all for watching. I love you all. And if you like this video, thumbs up and subscribe. I hope I could do more audio reviews. I just don't see myself buying anything else. So maybe there's a company out there that wants to send me something to compare to my reference system. I don't know. We'll see. So I will see you guys next time. Bye.